Chapter 35. Charlie found himself leaving Douro with a regret that he'd not anticipated. He would not miss Gillespie, but had formed a bond with Yowie and started to gain a perspective of his homeland, confirming the need to protect it from some of the changes in store from Western influences. A week later, he found himself in Moresby, attending a meeting alongside others, including patrol officers and senior policemen. Charlie was the only non-white face present. They were addressed by a Mr. Conrad, D.C., from the Madang province. It seemed that his problems sprang directly from the presence of cargo cults in the region under his administration. Charlie knew about the cults and had witnessed them firsthand in his youth. Conrad gave a brief talk on the subject and its history that originated from the time of the arrival of white men throughout the Pacific Islands. During World War II, the Allies had set up many temporary military bases in the Pacific. These introduced the isolated people of Papua New Guinea to huge quantities of highly desirable manufactured goods. Charlie's superstitious fellow Papua New Guinea inhabitants and other Pacific Islanders thought that these must have come from some distant ancestral world. They believed the source of these riches were controlled by a mythical figure known as John Frum. This name was possibly derived from the name of an American serviceman. One theory was that one of the first Americans to arrive announced himself as John Frum America. A cargo cult was formed, worshipping John Frum, with a belief that riches from his distant world would accrue to his followers. The people of the Madang region of New Guinea were only one of the many Melanesian islands of the Pacific to be gripped by a religious cult frenzy awaiting the return of Frum with unlimited cargo. To encourage John Frum to return, islanders indulged in practices aping the American military activities, including marching with wooden rifles with USA emblazoned on their bodies. Mock airports and airstrips were constructed. This was all difficult logic for the Western mind to follow, but very real to the believers.